Hey guys, I know this is going to be such a weird timing, to be honest, with the whole quote-unquote reboot of the channel. It's not really a reboot. Well, it's a reboot, but this is a serious video, if you can't tell by the title. I'm going to have a little thing uploaded after this, a normal video. We're going to go forward, so just expect to see a little thing in a minute, but anyways, we're going to turn the fan off for this video, for once. Instead of leaving the fan on, we're actually turning the fan off. That's how you know it's too serious. Anyway, so, for those who've been following me on my Facebook and Twitter, you know that stuff happened over the past week. At least I told people what was going to happen. And yesterday, it happened. So, yeah. Now it's too quiet in this house nowadays. That's why I said the timing's a little funny. I mean, I'm like the only YouTuber in history who would go through and demolish everything and be like, okay, hey, it's a reboot. It's either this or nothing. It's more than just that, apparently, though, because a little over a week ago, I had a talk with my mom, and then a few days later, she told me, yeah, I've known for a while, but it was definitely starting to show signs. Anyway, Shadow, my dog, she was 14 years old. She's been a part of this channel, all of my channels, Cloudy745, from the start till now. She was smaller back then, but, you know, she was just as much of a part of this channel as I was. Only because, you know, she was that dog in the background that everyone knew who would interrupt me or just bark for, like, 2 minutes fucking straight. And, you know, she was always there for 10 fucking years, basically. However long it's been. From now, then to now, you get my point. It's been a long time. But yeah, you read the title, you know where this is going. Yeah, a week ago we learned that my mom was going to be putting her down. Obviously not just for no reason. There were a lot of reasons. A lot of health things. And especially on the day they took her, they found some more things out. Shadow was put to sleep, passed away, whatever you want to say, yesterday, January 30th, 2017, at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. It wasn't exactly easy on my mom and dad at all. Not at all. My mom couldn't be in the room for that. My dad was. My mom and dad aren't handling it very well, because Shadow was a very good dog. She wasn't an asshole. She wasn't a shitty dog. She wasn't violent. She was a very kind and loving dog. So, it hasn't been easy for my mom and dad. It hasn't, I mean, for me, yeah, I've had my moments where I've already broke down, etc. Or I was depressed or I've cried because it's just, yeah, this is the first time I've really had to deal with this. I've had 3 dogs in my lifetime. I had a dog that was put to sleep when I was around 4. I don't really remember much about her. She was a Chihuahua. I do know her name. But back then, it didn't really occur to me too much what was going on. I remember being sad because I couldn't see the dog again. Then I had my own dog later, Einstein, a beagle. Yeah, he was put to sleep for a lot of reasons. He was violent and other things, and long story. But I loved my dog too, obviously. But back then, they put him to sleep without my knowledge. I wasn't even given a warning. I just came home and he was gone. I had no time to prepare, so that was depressing. With Shadow, it's different. I had a week to prepare to see the dog, knowing that in a week she was going to be gone forever, that I wouldn't be able to see her, pet her, give her treats, we'll play around with her, you know, just fucking throw a ball at her, toys, etc. Not throw a ball literally at her face, but you get my point. So it was just weird for me. And as it kept getting closer, I felt sick, and my anxiety started getting worse. And it's honestly, my anxiety doesn't feel too good right now as I'm talking about this, ever since I started having panic attacks. But yeah, basically, long story short, I could say as much as I will talk about. She wasn't eating anymore either. Shadow was becoming really skinny. She was like all bone. We couldn't like force her to eat. Like, she wouldn't even eat treats anymore, which is, that's weird. Her back leg kept giving out. There was something wrong with her. She had, like, some kind of twist or tumor things, like, in her leg and the right side of her face, I think, or something. But her leg kept giving out. there was just a lot of stuff. She wasn't doing well. She was, apparently it was just the right time to bring her in, because apparently, no, I didn't go with my mom and dad to put her to sleep, because I'm not the person who wants to see that. I had my time with her beforehand. The day I stayed up that day before she before they took her at 10:30 around that time, I spent time with her. I talked to her. I had my camera, so I took a few videos and then pictures. I took these ridiculous looking selfies. It's not really so. I just wanted to have a picture of me and the dog together, because I've never had that. As weird as that might sound, I'm a person who doesn't have a lot of pictures of me, so I didn't have anything with Shadow and I in the same picture, so I took it myself. It was, some of them were blurry, but that's the thing. That's the last thing I did. The last thing I did before I went to sleep, because I had to sleep. I wasn't sleeping, and I knew when I woke up I wouldn't see my dog again, and that depressed me. I knew that when I woke up, her dog bed, which by the way is right outside my door, would be empty now forever. There would be no more piddle pads on the ground to stop her from peeing or pooping on the ground. It would just, everything would be different. It's weird to me, and now she won't be barking when the people show up to, you know, deliver stuff or et cetera at the same time. She won't. It's just too quiet. Yeah. The last thing I did before I went to sleep was I was just petting her and, you know, talking to her, and she understands some English. She did. I don't care. There's definitely things she knew. But, I don't know. I spent time with her. I took nice pictures with her. And then she went upstairs to see Mom and Dad. And that was it. The last thing I remember doing with Shadow was I took a picture of her and I together. And then I went to sleep. And she was, I'll never see her again. So, yeah. It's depressing. What's weird is after she was gone, her ball somehow randomly ended up under the table where she used to sleep. So that's definitely something, but yeah. So anyways, for those who don't follow me on Facebook and Twitter, I just wanted to make this video and let you know that, yes, Shadow has passed away. She had to be put to sleep because there was nothing that we could do. We don't have all the money in the world to be able to do things. America fucking sucks with things. And even if we could, I don't know, because I heard, I don't think you guys want to hear this. Anyways. I don't really know. I don't really want to say much. I don't really want to talk about this too much. I'd rather just move on and, you know, not like, don't forget about the dog. You know, always think about her, etc. And sure, it won't be the same not hearing the dog barking in the background, but I don't know. You can always pretend. I might start streaming again, too. I don't know. If you don't want to hear a few things, I'd recommend you turn the video off now. But, hold on. Before you turn the video off, if you're going to, just know that she's at peace now and, you know, etc. I'm going to be uploading some stuff very shortly, so look forward to that. I myself still feel a bit shitty. I feel like I'm always going through with this anxiety. I feel like I'm dying daily, but I'm okay, I guess. But really quick, I do want to talk about what I heard from my dad and my mom. But for some people might not want to hear this. That's why I'm saying if they don't want to, they should probably just not listen. It's about when they were putting her to sleep. My mom wasn't in the room. Anyways, I'm going to talk about it now. So, Shadow, I don't know, apparently she was so skinny, they had a hard time finding the vein or something for, you know, the needle. So they had to shave things, like parts of her, like hair, so they could see things. But even then, Shadow was definitely still, she had fight in her. She was scared and she wanted out of the room. And she just wanted to come back home, obviously, which is depressing. And every time I say that, it makes me want to fucking cry, but apparently she just kept wanting to get out of the room. She tried her hardest to just run away, which honestly, I know why she did, and she was scared and confused. And apparently they had to put a mask muzzly thing on her to put her to sleep and use the injection. But apparently, because of her struggling like she did, the tumor, or whatever the fuck it was, in her right leg exploded. So, yeah. didn't kill her, but that's great. I'm glad to know that. No, I don't know why I'm really saying this. It frustrates me for some reason to hear that. You know, I like to just know, it's like, I like to just think about, oh, everything went okay, the dog went, you know, peacefully, and on and on. No. No, instead, it angers me, it depresses me, and I just don't like knowing that it things have to be that fucking ridiculous. Whatever. And my dad said she looked peaceful when she was going out, but I don't know. So, anyways. Yeah. I don't know if I'll have this be up for too long, because really, I just want everyone to know what happened. And once that's the case and everyone moves on to the videos, no one's going to see this anyways. I mean, no one's going to want to watch it, but for those that remember Shadow, I know you always remember that dog who was barking in the back, who was a happy dog. She had a lot of happiness. It was just in the end, she was very sick. And I have pictures of her. I have some. I have a lot of pictures of just, oops, of her, like, by herself and stuff, and I probably put them on the video, and you could probably see a few of them, so. Yeah. Also, the picture I took with her on the last day myself, with me in it, totally wasn't wearing my shirt. No one wants to see me like that. No one wants to see that. Anyways, but whatever. I'm gonna hook up my camera to the computer right now so I could, get some of these pictures off my camera. You hear me getting the USB right now from my camera. Anyways, sorry for... Why is this USB being stupid? Okay, you're gonna hear USB sound, guys. You ready? Don't. It's not your computer. Don't worry. Here we go. Okay, whatever. It was quiet. Anyways, why'd I do it twice? Anyways, I just want to let you guys know that. And yeah, for everyone who said kind things on Facebook or Twitter, I did read everything. Sorry for not responding. I've just been a little, you know, down, and it's very different in the house right now with Shadow gone. So, yeah. I'll see you guys shortly with stuff. Probably a lot of stuff that no one's going to give a shit about. But hey, I'm doing what I want to do. It's my channel. Whatever, you know. I just want to be helpful until I fucking die myself. Anyways, I'ma go. Oh, and unrelated to everything I said in this video, Resident Evil 7 was a great game. You should buy it. Anyways, I am going to go for now. And anyways, rest in peace, Shadow. She'll always be remembered, never forgotten. She was always a huge part of this channel in her own little way. So yeah. Now the channel's going forward. Shadow's obviously still in some of my older videos, and if I do the re-upload channel, I will let you guys know about it, don't worry. I haven't done anything yet, so I'm gonna just shut up now. Bye.